ท่านสมชายเสียงหลาย Advisor to the Justice Ministry Your Excellency Mr. Jeffrey Doyce Ambassador of South Africa Mr. Jeremy Douglas Regional Representative of the United Nations Office on Drug and Crime for Southeast Asia and the Pacific Dr. Ayut Senthopan Deputy Director General of Department of Correction Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor today to join all of you in observance of the Nelson Mandela International Day. It is also my privilege to witness the launching event, which marks the important step in the implementation of the Nelson Mandela rules in Thailand. President Nelson Mandela of South Africa is a truly inspiring role model for countless people all over the world. Therefore, it is a very good opportunity for us to honor his legacy and his lifetime dedication to promote a culture of peace and freedom. I would like to take a few steps back and recall when the United Nations Standard Minimum Rules for the treatment of offenders, also known as the SMR, were under revision by the first expert group meeting in 2011. At that time, Thailand, as well as several UN member states present here today, took part in that review process. Although the task at hand to review and update the international standards in existence for over 5 decades, was not at all easy, but through collective efforts of the international communities and with the support from UNODC, the revision of the SMRs finally came into conclusion in December 2015. South Africa, host of the final meeting of the expert group and homeland of President Nelson Mandela, played an important role in this achievement. Therefore, it is very fitting that the revised rules are now known as the Nelson Mandela Rules, in honor of the late President Nelson Mandela. Under the update provisions, member states are encouraged to ensure that the mechanisms are in place and strengthened to uphold and promote the inherent dignity of prisoners in all aspects. The revision focused on 8 specific areas of prison operation considered most urgently in need of improvement. Therefore, it is necessary that countries put the rules into practice in order to promote humane correctional system. For the Thailand Institute of Justice, or TIJ, we are committed to the promotion of the rights-based criminal justice system. As a member of the United Nations Crime Prevention and Criminal Justice Program Network, or the UNPNIs, TIJ gears our work toward promoting the implementation of the United Nations standards and norms related to the treatment of offenders in order to ensure that the basic human rights of those deprived of their liberty and those who come into contact with the justice system are respected nationally and internationally. This is why I'm really delighted to learn that the initiative by the Department of Correction, together with the Thonburi Remand Prison, to implement the Nelson Mandela rules in Thailand. Of course, TIJ stands ready to support this cause. For the past 3 years, TIJ and the Department of Corrections have jointly embarked on a very special project called the Bangkok Rules Model Prison. The project is aimed at translating the United Nations rules for the treatment of women prisoners and the non-custodial measures for women offenders, or the Bangkok rules, into practice. In search for the Bangkok rules model prisons, we focus on the assessment of practical operations, prison facilities, and the awareness among prison staff on gender sensitivity. From 2014 to 2016, we were able to identify 6 model prisons with another 5 under assessment this year. There are a number of important considerations when we start the Bangkok Blue Model Prison project, and the rigorous assessment was one of them. To that end, we began by developing an assessment tool which takes into account the UN guidelines, existing tools, and Thailand context. The assessment tool was tested and revised several times before being finalized. Equally important ingredient for this project is the willingness of prison staff to make positive changes, particularly for the sustainability of the project. Thus, capacity building activities have always been at the core of the project to enhance prison staff understanding so as to make change from within. For this new Mandela Rules initiative, TIJ will continue to support the Department of Correction and Thonburi Remand Prison and provide technical assistance needed for the implementation of this project. I believe that we could similarly envisage a joint project for the Mandela Rules Model Prison based on a standardized assessment tool and process. Several useful materials developed by UNODC, particularly the assessment tool, will certainly be useful for the implementation of this project. Ladies and gentlemen, Thailand is not alone in this effort to improve national correctional practice. In August 2016, TIJ and Penal Reform International host the Southeast Asia Regional Consultation on the implementation of the Nelson Mandela Rules for the first time. It was agreed by representatives of several countries in this region that the provisions of the Mandela Rule should be adhered to and understood by correctional staff. Also, it was noted that awareness raising and capacity building are the primary step toward successful implementation of the rules. To enhance understanding of prison officers in Thailand, TIJ has recently published the Mandela Rules Short Guide in Thai language. We hope the document would be useful for Thai correctional staff to understand the rationale behind the revision of SMRs and keep abreast of the key areas that have been updated. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mandela Rules place the highest importance on the respect for the inherent dignity, human dignity of prisoners, and on the prohibition of tortures and other inhuman treatments. This is not merely because such principles are in line with international human rights obligation, but because humane treatment and prison condition are crucial to reform prison into a place conducive to the rehabilitation and reintegration. With the effective program in place, prison administration can contribute to the reduction of recidivism, which is an essential goal of criminal justice system as a whole. A high proportion of crime and prison population in Thailand are driven by drug offenses, while poverty and lack of access to education and employment are crucial contributing factors. Mr. Mandela once said, and I would like to quote, "For to be free is not merely to cast off one's chains, but to live in a way that respects and enhances the freedom of others." Therefore, I believe that prison can be more than a place of detention. It can offer prisoners new skills, knowledge, and opportunity to change their life for the better after release. Last but not least, I would like to emphasize that to realize the importance of justice and the rule of law is to realize common humanity, the concept that Mr. Mandela himself held as a pinnacle of a peaceful society. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, which was adopted by the General Assembly in 2015, also ensured the commitment to leave no one behind. TIJ believed that this pilot initiative to implement the Mandela Rules correspond with the international effort and will contribute to the peaceful and inclusive society in the country. Finally, I would like to once again congratulate the Department of Corrections and Thonburi Remand Prison for taking this very important initiative, and would like to reaffirm that TIJ stand ready to help in any way on this project, in any possible way that we can. Thank you very much.